Ableton Live's Wavetable Synthesizer comes with a plethora of wavetables, yielding numerous options of timbre. Let's take a closer look at how to select and change the wavetables.
So what is a wavetable? A wavetable is simply a collection of short looping samples that are arranged together. Here I've loaded up the Spectrum device, which I can explode in order to see the harmonic content of the sound and how it changes when we scan through the wavetable position. If you play a note with the oscillators fixed to one of these samples, you're going to have a steady tone with a consistent timbre. The real power of wavetable synthesis comes by moving between the various samples in the table as the notes play. This results in a shifting and dramatic timbre. Wavetable comes with 12 categories, giving you the option of selecting more than 100 wavetables, ranging from classic hardware synths to acoustic instruments, the harmonic series, and various types of noises, angelic pads, and many more. Let's take a look at the basic shapes. Here, we can move the wavetable position from a sine wave, to a triangle, to an upward saw, and all the way up to the square wave. The true power of wavetable synthesis comes from scanning through the tables. On the modulation matrix, I can use the LFO to change the wavetable position of oscillator 1, and this creates the dramatic change of timbre that you're hearing. Let's open up wavetable's interface and add in the second oscillator. Here we can see all the movement happening. So there are no filters applied to the oscillators. It's just the timbral change being introduced by moving through the wavetable. Let's create an epic pad. So on track 2, in the complex category, I've selected the wavetable dubstep organ. Check out how it sounds. So this is a complex waveform, and by scanning through the wavetable, we can hear how the timbre changes gradually. This is nice to add in if you want some more characteristic sounds. So let's open up wavetable's interface and add in the second oscillator. This is from the distortion category and is called Malice. Look at the hard shapes of the wavetable. This is easy to hear. We're having some very harsh sounds, and altogether, we've created a very nice, lush sound. As I mentioned earlier, the true power of wavetable synthesis comes from modulation. So let me increase the global amount of modulation here, which will add movement to the wavetable position and the filter frequencies. On track 3, I'm running an arpeggio with a wavetable from the former category. It's called Aio, and it's the vowel sounds. To create some movement, I'm using LFO 2 in retrigger mode. This means that whenever a key is pressed, the LFO restarts. Alright, let's beef up this sound by adding in the second oscillator, which takes its table from the instrument category and marimba. Check out how it sounds on its own. So a cool thing that I added here in the modulation matrix is that the pitch value, the note that I'm playing, is affecting the wavetable position. With a negative value, a higher pitch will result in a lower position in the wavetable. If I increase the number, higher pitches will result in a higher position in the wavetable. Okay, let's hear both oscillators together. Almost there. Let's beef it up a notch more by adding in the sub oscillator. Boom, super rich sound. Let's hear the full composition all together. If you feel the need to add even more sounds to wavetable, you're able to import your own custom waves under the user category. Alright, that's it. Enjoy having fun with wavetable.